Hey everybody, Anthony here with Aces Adventures, and welcome back to another Dead Mall excursion. This time we are in the capital region at the Amsterdam Mall, now known as the Riverfront Complex. And this mall has a lot of history. It pretty much is no longer a mall right now. It pretty much operates as an office and different social service procedures, and also hosts, as you'll hear in the background, a lot of Spanish churches. There is a heavy Latino population in this area. So like I said, this is basically not a mall anymore. It's more of an office complex. And at least the great thing about this mall, as you'll see in the video, is the aesthetics in this mall, the vintage aesthetics, as I always say, are off the charts. And you will definitely see that in this video. The mall actually was built in the 70s, and as we walk through the mall here, you can obviously tell that it is 70s designed to a T, and the mall was built, it was part of an urban renewal project in the 1970s, and they actually tore out several blocks of Main Street to build this property here. And as we walk through this here, I just want to mention briefly just how amazing it was to see these globes in person. And another thing is, it's so quiet in here. Originally, this mall, I didn't think I was ever going to get out to see it because I looked on the website and it just said Monday through Friday, but then found out through a local source that the property actually is open 7 days a week for various churches and other organizations as well, and was even told during the week it is rather busy in here due to the fact that, like I said, it hosts several social service applications and public, you know, facilities, so it can be actually pretty busy during the week here as we get this close-up shot of these amazing globes. So like I said, this was an urban renewal project in the 70s, and it took up several blocks of Main Street and has been on the downfall for quite a while, and there really is no major competition for this mall. The Albany Mall would be the closest, or the malls in the Albany capital region would be the biggest competition, if any, but this mall has been, you know, essentially vacant. You know, there's businesses in here, but it really has no purpose as a mall other than it looks like a mall. A unique one at that, but a mall nonetheless. A lot of these downtown malls that I've been to have a very similar small design. They're not as sprawled out as other malls because they had to make do with less space, but still nonetheless amazing to see in its own right. This mall did have a cinema as well too, and unfortunately the cinema signage was down, but as you saw in the opening shot there of the ticket booth window. And the mall is very small, also at only 255,000 square feet. So, gonna let you guys enjoy the rest of the video here. Hopefully, you're enjoying the new content for 2018. There is much more content coming. As I announced earlier in a live stream, I will be heading to the Atlanta region on June 23rd, and I will be spending several days in Atlanta, North Carolina, South Carolina, Virginia, going all up the East Coast, going to see tons and tons of malls. And if you are excited about that trip and want to help me be able to see more content, the best way to do so is by becoming a Patreon donor at patreon.com/acesadventures. All of that money 100% goes back into future travels. And also follow me on Instagram and Twitter at acesadventures1 on Instagram and Twitter, and follow along for all of the latest Dead Mall content right here from Aces Adventures.
I'm not taking pictures of you guys.
No, no, dude, don't worry about it.
This place is awesome. I love the vintage aesthetics. I'm just coming back from New York City. I want to stop here. I live in Buffalo. And I